Hello, hello, everybody. Coach Phil here. I know that we are in a little bit of a crisis. I know that the entire world is going through some kind of crisis right now. And I just wanted to come to you today and say, hey, first of all, it is important that we accept that we're in a crisis. And therefore, we decide that what are we going to do about it, okay? Yes, people are going to die. There's no question about it. Yes, it is going to be a question of you know, who can survive through it, and what have you done, or what can we do to make sure that we all come out better, stronger, and or even much more successful than ever before. It is inevitable. We are in a crisis. That is for sure. Okay. Now, if you're still thinking, oh, maybe, maybe not, it is here. But most importantly, what is going to be important is now is when we will see how resilient you are. Now is when we're going to see what happens, how you respond. You know, there's that saying that says it is not how hard you fall that makes a difference, it's how first you get up that makes a difference. Now, the virus is not the real problem. This is my own take. The virus is not the real problem, okay? The real problem is the second and third degree or third order consequences, okay? Look, the virus, you know, the biggest challenge is that one person can infect four people, okay? That means that let us just hypothetically say that there's a population of 10 million wherever you live, 10 million people, and 50% of those people are going to get infected. Now, I don't know which part of the world you live, but wherever you are, if 50% of 10 million is going to be infected, that means 5 million people are going to be infected. Now, when we talk about the second and third degree consequences, this is what we mean. If 5 million people get infected, I know from statistics and from having looked at what is going on in the world, there is not many countries that have 5 million beds, all right? There's not many people that have 5 million beds or hospitals with 5 million beds. What does that mean? There is going to be a chock-a-block. The hospitals are going to be chock-a-block. The health systems are going to be stretched. What does that mean? That means that if you have an accident and or anything that happens on the road, you cannot see a doctor because the doctors are what? That is when you begin to feel the real consequences of what is going on, okay? So the real problem is not the virus. The real problem is the second, third, and fourth consequences going down there. So first things first, accept that it is here. Second thing, take responsibility for yourself and say, okay, I'm going to do something about it, okay? I am going to make sure that I look after myself. I'm going to lead. I'm going to make sure that all the people I care about are taking the right decisions and are being responsible. Why? Because it is yours and my duty to make sure that we stop this particular spread. So, first things first, if you're working or if you're an entrepreneur, whatever it is, find a way to isolate yourself or find your way to work from home or whatever, okay? Why? It is important to stop the spread. The only way we can stop it is if we isolate ourselves for the next 20, 30, 40 days until the freaking thing dies out, okay? So after isolating, let us get into the real deal of what we need to do. Number one, look after your mind. It's a mindset thing. Be positive about it, okay? You can't change the fact that coronavirus is here. You can't change that. But you can prepare yourself to say, you know what? I'm going to look after myself. I'm going to be healthy. I'm going to focus on what I'm going to do out of this crisis rather than where we are. I'll give you a quick story. Yesterday, one of my clients sent me a message at 6 a.m. in the morning saying, you know what, coach? This coronavirus thing is really affecting our strategy that we discussed 2 months ago. And I don't know what to do. And you could clearly tell she was in a bit of a panic, okay? Now, where I come from, I had already seen that there's going to be another opportunity. Listen, if you're in the business of selling something or getting out, all businesses are going to be affected. But what are you going to do different? Number one, have the right mindset, okay? Know that this is the time for you to think. This is the time for you to say, okay, how do I still serve my customers better? You can't do that unless you're looking after your mind and you're what? Protecting it. So, number one, look after your mind. What does that mean? Get enough sleep. Get enough rest. Number two, make sure you are taking time to pray and meditate and do all those things. Number three, in terms of your health, make sure that you are hydrating, that you're taking some vitamins and you're eating healthy. Number four, cut out the alcohol, cut out the smoking. Do whatever it takes to make sure the machine remains healthy. Even if you get sick, which most of us are going to, guess what? You will be able to bounce back quicker, better, because you have looked after yourself, okay? Next, after you make sure, in terms of the mindset, make sure that you are protecting it against all the negative vibes out there. There's a lot of negative rubbish out there. Get off the news, okay? Only listen to the news that is important. Just get off the news, okay? If it is important, somebody's going to call you, all right? Make sure you get into your prayer and meditation. That's important. I know whatever it is, I don't care who you believe in, whatever. I believe in God. I pray, I meditate, take time to work on this, because when this is sorted, when you are okay up here, then everything is going to be okay. Then, of course, the health side of things. Exercise. Do some exercise. Take a walk. Do some teaching. I don't care what you do. Make sure you do some exercise, okay? Now, that's the first part of how we're going to survive and thrive out of the crisis. After you've done that, now is also the time to take a step back and begin to observe, to take a step back and get some perspective. What is going on in the world right now? Where is all the panic? Why are people panicking? Why are you panicking? What is that one thing that has gotten you panic? I'm going to tell you, it is either all those things that you've wanted to do and you haven't been able to do it, and you're thinking, shit, in case it ends now, I am done. Maybe now is the time to bring out your beast mode and say, you know what? I'm going to start doing something seriously about this. I am going to get the book that I wanted to write, whatever it is, bring it to the front burner now, because you're going to have time, and sit down and say, I'm going to execute on this. I'm going to do this. Why? You're in isolation anyway. So you might as well use your isolation to do something useful. People are going to be in isolation. They're going to spend time on TV. That is where the problem is. The news is designed to get us crazy. No. Be in state. When you get up, get rid of all that stuff and say, okay, maybe it's now time for me to write that book. Maybe it's now everybody who is above 18 has got something to teach. Maybe it's now time for you to invest in a course. Maybe it is now time for you. Listen, 30 days on Google getting information is a long time. Maybe it's now time for you to do that, okay? It is important that you take the time that you're having time off to what? To reinvest, to do what you have to do, or to do what we call sharpening the saw. Prepare. Do what you have to do so that when the time comes, when we're out of this, you are so sharp, it is unbelievable. You're going to be at the forefront. Why? You have worked on yourself. You have worked on your skill. You have sharpened yourself. You've probably become a better writer, speaker, trainer, whatever it is. Now is the time. When is even a better time now to become a world-class speaker and consultant? Maybe it's now time for you to start thinking, okay, how can I serve the world better? Hey, maybe, just maybe, it's also a call to you to say, you know what? I've been employed for the last 18 years, and guess what? Now I'm in a position where the employer is cutting down. It is inevitable. The employer is going to cut down. What do I need to do? There's nothing as important right now as protecting and or bring out your, what we call your IP, your intellectual property, and digitizing it and putting it out there, okay? Why? You can have people who are in their homes pay you for that. I don't care what it is. There's a person who teaches knitting in Australia who makes a lot of money because people are watching her videos on knitting. Maybe now is the time for you to do that, all right? So, look after your mind. Get your intellectual property going. Use the time to invest in your mind and do what you have to do and prepare. Next, I want you to now also challenge yourself. Find something you can do in the next 30 days that you have been putting off, okay? Get fitter, for example, or learn chess, or learn how to play guitar, whatever. But do something that has challenged you. Do something that is going to challenge you so that out of the crisis, you get out with a win. You get out and you're feeling, you know what? Much as there was all this negativity going on, I came out much better. I came out much bigger. I just told the guys who are part of a very elite, very small group of speakers, I just gave them a challenge for the next 30 days. I need them to come up with a video every day for 30 days. Okay, why? People are in their homes. People can afford to watch something. Come out with something, teach something, write something, whatever it is. Now is the time, okay? Most importantly, surround yourself with people who are on the same journey with you, okay? Now it has never been a bigger, better time for you to connect more with the people you love, to connect more with the people who are important to you, to connect more with the people who are on the same journey, okay? Now is the time, right? When I say get off social media, get off, you know, discussing gnosis, okay? Get on there to do the connections, to be in rhythm with what is going on with the entrepreneurs who are making things happen, okay? So whatever you do in the next 30, 40 days, whatever time it's going to take, understand, number one, it is here, it is going to happen. Number two, people are going to die. Number three, you're going to look after yourself. You're going to get out stronger, bigger, better, and you're going to make a difference to your life and to somebody else. So until next time, remember to live strong, live with passion, and know that you have the audacity to live life on your terms. Coach Phil, see you on the other side.